Hey guys, welcome to Elevate Techie. If you haven't done yet, hit that subscribe button so that you'll never miss any video of mine. And welcome to another video of the playlist, How to Develop a Real-Time BDD Framework Using Selenium with Java. In this video, I'll be explaining the design of the BDD automation framework, which we are doing in this whole playlist. So let's get started. So the first file we have in this automation BDD framework is pom.xml file. So this is basically an XML file, and we get this pom.xml file created by default for every Maven project. So what does this file contains? So this pom.xml file stores all the dependencies which you want to use for the project, like Selenium, Cucumber, TestNG. All of those dependencies will be defined in this pom.xml file. And apart from that, we do define the plugins which we want to use for executing our scenarios. So this is what this pom.xml file consists of. Later we have got test runner file. So test runner file is basically a Java file, and it is kind of a main method in Java. So you know that for any of the Java, the execution starts from the main method. So in the similar way, for the Cucumber project, we have this test runner file where we will be defining all our attributes like the tags, features and the steps, and we'll define what scenarios we want to run so that it will pick those scenarios and starts the execution. So you can say that execution basically starts from this test runner file. And later we have got hooks file. So we have concept of hooks in Cucumber, where it is providing us with the at the rate of before and at the rate of after hooks. So in the at the rate of before, we will be defining the code logic which we want to implement before executing any of the scenario. And in the similar way, in at the rate of after annotation, we will be defining the code logic which we want to implement after execution of any scenario. So once you get the scenario identified from the test runner file, it will be looking if there were any hooks defined like at the rate of before, so that it will execute that code before executing the actual scenario. So the hooks file is also a .java file. And next is the feature file. So this is actually a .feature file, and it is the place where we'll be designing all our scenarios in the Cucumber BDD framework. So we'll be writing all the scenarios for the application in the feature files using the Gherkins language. And also Cucumber provides us with the facility of adding the test data as well in this feature files. So once it identifies the scenarios in the test runner, it will execute the hooks, and after that it starts with the execution by identifying the scenarios in the feature file. And next, the execution goes to step definition file. So step definition file is a .java file where we'll be implementing every test step we have designed in this feature file. So for any scenario, whatever the steps we have designed, all of them we need to implement in this step definition file for the execution to go on. So from the scenario identification, it finds that scenario and goes to every step and checks for the same step in the step definition file. And the next part of the execution goes to page implementation file. So page implementation file is also a .java file, and in this file we'll be defining the actual logic of the code for all the actions we want to perform for a particular test in the application. So it contains all the Java code implementing the logic of the test. And later we have got the WebDriver util files. This is also a .java file, and in this file we'll be defining the web driver which we want to use. We'll be creating the object of the web driver, and also we'll set the properties of the web driver we want, like maximizing the window and deleting the cookies and setting the desired capabilities for the browser. So everything related to the driver will be set in this web driver util file. And the code from the web driver util file will be used by this page implementation file. And for the next part of the execution, we have the Selenium support functions file. This is even a Java file, and this file actually contains all the Selenium support functions like click method and sendKeys method. So we'll be implementing all the methods related to the Selenium so that we can use it anywhere. The page implementation file will be making use of this Selenium support functions to perform any of the action for the test. And in the later part of the execution, we have got defaultenvironment.properties. So this is a .properties file, and in this file we will be defining all the environment properties related to the application. So that can be of the URL of the application, username, password, and the environment we want to run, and the DB we want to connect. So all of those properties related to the application will be defined in this .properties file. And finally, we have got the log4j.properties file. And the purpose of the log4j in the automation framework is that to get the logs of the execution we do. So using the log4j.properties file, we'll be implementing the log4j to get all the logs for the scenarios which we are executing. So precisely, these are all the files which we are going to create and design in our future videos. And when you keep any of the scenario for the execution, you can say that first it will download all the dependencies using this pom.xml file, and then it will go to the test runner file to identify which test scenario it has to run. So once it finds the condition which it has to look for, then it will go to the hooks file where it will execute any of the hooks like at the rate of before which we have defined. And once that is executed, it will go and look for the scenario with this particular condition we have defined in this test runner file. And once it finds the scenario with that particular tag, it will start the execution and look for the test steps it has to perform. And for every step, it will look in the step definition file for that particular step implementation. So once it finds the implementation of that step, then it will execute the code logic for that step which we have defined in this base implementation file. And this base implementation file will make use of the web driver util file and the Selenium support functions to call the driver and perform the actions which we want to do for a test. So this is how the execution flow goes on in a BDD Cucumber framework. This is all about the BDD framework structure in our project. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you learned something new today. Please do like, share, and subscribe the channel, and see you in the next video.